children on the importance of celebrating diversity, from self-esteem to
Rose Vision.
Fox Kids is...
We're the Plattsburgh High School Drama Players from Plattsburgh, Missouri.
Good morning, America!
They provide the drama of the morning. We provide the show. Good morning, America. I'm Charles Gibson.
And I'm Joan Lennon. It is Wednesday, September 4th. And coming up, the U.S. launches a second missile attack on southern Iraq. We will get you caught up on all the latest developments in just a moment.
Yeah, we're going to get reaction to that second strike in Iraq from three members of the Senate Armed Services Committee, Senators Warner, McCain, and Nunn. Also, how to protect your money from the stock market's ups and downs. We'll get some advice on how to invest defensively from our money editor, Tyler Matheson, will be here again in this half hour.
And then, what would you do if you found your daughter having sex with her boyfriend there in your house? Well, we will talk to a father whose actions almost cost him his job. Right now, though, let us get the latest on Iraq and all the other morning's news developments from Elizabeth Vargas. Elizabeth?
Good morning, Joan. Hello again, everybody. Our top story, the second round of missile strikes against Iraq. Before dawn today, Baghdad time, the U.S. launched 17 more cruise missiles from three ships and one submarine in the Persian Gulf. The Pentagon calls it a mop-up operation aimed at military targets missed in yesterday's attack. And this morning, officials say Allied pilots are ready to start enforcing the expanded no-fly zone over southern Iraq.
We wanted to do everything possible to reduce the risk to our air crews. So our strikes yesterday were designed to reduce the threats to our airplanes and our pilots enforcing the no-fly zone.
The UN Security Council will meet again today to discuss the situation in the Gulf. Yesterday, members could not agree on a response to the U.S. operation. In this country, however, initial public reaction to the president's handling of the Iraq situation is positive. An ABC News Nightline poll shows 79% of those questioned approved of the first missile strike. As for which major presidential candidate could better handle any war with Iraq, 56% picked Bill Clinton, 33% chose Bob Dole. In other news this morning, former President Ronald Reagan has been awarded more than $500,000 by a federal appeals court. The reimbursement is for legal costs incurred while the former president was being investigated for an illegal arms sale to Iran during his administration. Mr. Reagan was not indicted. And that's a very quick look at the news this morning at 7:32. Let's go upstairs now to Spencer Christian for a look at the weather.
Okay, Elizabeth. Hurricane Fran has gained strength over the last 24 hours. Here's satellite animation of the development of the storm in the last day, or actually during the overnight hours as it moves through the South Atlantic and the Caribbean. High sustained winds, 115 miles per hour. The storm will move north of the Bahamas today and deal a hurricane blow to those islands. Hurricane Watch, meanwhile, is in effect for much of the U.S. South Atlantic coast. The storm is centered about 500 miles southeast of Charleston, South Carolina at the moment. Today there will be heavy rain in the east not associated with Fran, which probably will not make landfall until early Friday morning. So heavy rain in much of the east. Afternoon thunderstorms, powerful ones rumbling through the southern plains and southern Rockies and becoming damp and cool in the Pacific Northwest. That's a look at the national weather. Here's a look at the weather where you are.
Temperatures now in most locations are in the 60s. We do have a cloudy gray day with off and on rain showers and sprinkles, the high 73. Mainly cloudy tonight, the risk of a shower, the low 62.
Known the Clintons for years, one of the only people who knows the truth about Whitewater. Susan McDougal speaks for the first time, a Primetime Live exclusive tonight.
I can't work. I can't get anything done because I just keep picturing, you know?
Girl looks
56, 65.
While the other suffered more serious.
Now, live from the news station.
Skies, which is set during the Kennedy administration, and it's all about a big government cover-up that involves an alien invasion that's somehow tied to a JFK assassination. There's another one called The Pretender, which is about a guy who can assume the identity of anybody he chooses to. He becomes a sea captain, he becomes a pilot, he becomes a surgeon. This is not exactly very reassuring to me as a viewer that the guy who might be operating on me is, you know, a pretender. There's another show called Profiler, which is, you know, Silence of the Lambs. This is also about a kind of a female forensic psychologist who goes to a crime scene and she kind of gets the vibrations of what happened. And but this is more like the talkiness of the lambs. It's this very, very, the dialogue just won't stop.
But if you're dubious about those, which of any of these do you like?
Well, there is one on Fox called Millennium, which is created by the guy who did The X-Files, Chris Carter. Right. And I think that's a really interesting show because, for one thing, it stars Lance Hendrickson, who a lot of people may not know that name, but that he's a character actor you might know. He usually plays a villain in movies like Alien. And what I like about this is that he's another one of these guys who investigates grisly murder scenes, but it's done with some depth. It kind of questions morality and questions of good and evil in a way that a lot of shows like that don't dig below that surface.
We have a clip from Millennium. Let's take a look.
I see what the killer sees.
What, like a psychic?
No. I put myself in his head. I become the thing we fear the most.
How?
I become capability. I become the horror. What we know we can become only in our heart of darkness. It's my gift. It's my curse.
And you think he has no curse, but he becomes a hit.
I think he's blessed, yes.
All right, how about sitcoms? As I say, I don't know much about the fall season, but I think the number is 3,241 new sitcoms.
I think so, yeah. That's certainly what it seemed like to me. Michael J. Fox is in a new sitcom called Spin City that I think is the best written show of the year.
Really?
I mean, you know, it's just such a relief. You see Michael J. Fox come on the screen as this hustling deputy mayor of New York City, tossing out orders, striding down a hall, and you just relax because Fox is like such an old pro, you know, that it's just, it's at once a comforting show and a real energetic show. I think it's really well done.
But you point to what is so key in all these shows, which is the writing.
Yes.
Again, we have a clip. Let's take a look.
All right, everybody, listen up. As of about 1 minute ago, Sanitation Workers Union rejected our final offer. They are now officially on strike.
Oh, my God.
It's happening? So let's start looking into alternative dump sites, all right? Vacant lots, barges, New Jersey.
One of the things I noticed in all of these previews that the networks run, because they try to run clips to get you to watch, a lot of big names are doing shows. Brooke Shields, Ted Danson is back, mm-hmm. and yet I hear some of those shows already in trouble.
Yeah, it's an amazing phenomenon. The Brooke Shields show, Suddenly Susan, they had filmed a pilot, they had sent it out to critics, and then they scrapped it because there's just so much pressure riding on shows becoming an instant hit. They don't want to leave shows on the air for too many.
But how do they know it's in trouble?
Well, they do a lot of testing with audience, preview audiences, and if those people don't think this is the funniest thing they've ever seen in their life, they turn thumbs down on that, and the networks get real nervous. Everybody looks for a big breakout hit immediately. In the case of the Ted Danson show, Inc., it's teams Ted Danson with Mary Steenburgen, his partner in real life. And they actually said, there's not enough chemistry between these two. Right? so they go back and they scrap the first four shows. They bring in Diane English, who created Murphy Brown, and said, please help fix this show.
Bottom line, good season, bad season, mediocre.
Charlie, I've come to think of it as a meatloaf of mediocrity with a few onions of excellence. I think that's about it.
On your breakfast cereal, I will leave you with that image in your mind. Ken, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Joan?
All right, and as we continue our fall preview, a word of advice. We're told turn off the beach music and turn on to some great new music that you've just got to hear. Listen to this.
Gypsy Scott is driving his big long yellow car. She flies like a bird.
Yes, John Mellencamp is back, and don't blink, he nabbed none other than hot actor Matthew McConaughey to appear in the video for his new song, Key West Intermezzo, I Saw You First. And then, of course, all was first with the latest in music. We've invited John Sykes back, president of VH1. Good to have you here. Why do they wait? I mean, this is the big, big time. I always hear this. Right after Labor Day, they bring everything out.
Well, Labor Day weekend, Joan, is like a light switch for record sales. Vacations are over. People are back from to school, back to work.
Yeah, kids are back in their rooms putting in the CDs.
And they're back in record stores. And that's when the record companies want to put their biggest guns out there because it's a setup time for their sellers for Christmas. Whatever you set up now will be your biggest seller for Christmas.
Ooh, okay. All right, then let's start with John Mellencamp since we just heard a little bit of that.
Yeah, it's the album's called Mr. Happy-Go-Lucky.
Mr. Happy-Go-Lucky, and you say it's great.
This is a great record. This is John's most adventurous record since Lonesome Jubilee back in 1987, and his best. John takes his trademark rock sound and mixes it with acoustic country and a little bit of even urban sound. He even used Madonna's producer to work on it with him. Great record.
All right, R.E.M. also coming out. Now that one comes, like, we should say, into the stores, Mellencamp, next year.
Next week.
Next week. Okay.
And so is R.E.M.
next
record,
week, okay.
Which is called New Adventures in Hi-Fi. What's remarkable about R.E.M. is that this band is forever young. There are 35-year-olds who... There are 35-year-olds who really grew up with this band in college. Who
and are going to love this again.
They're going to love this again.
And their kids are going to love it.
18-year-olds who are singing for the first time. And that's really the key. That's what a U2 and the Rolling Stones have done so well.
Yeah, now this is Ebo. Is that
Ebo
the letter? And that's from the new album?
Featuring backing vocals by Patti Smith.
Wow, that's really something for... These combinations are incredible.
Yes, they're amazing. And it's really to see R.E.M. reach back with a great artist like Patti Smith to pay tribute to her and what she's done in music. This is a great record. Comes out next week.
Okay, Sheryl Crow. I mean, here she comes out with that, just that, you know, so successful album. Has she followed it up with another success?
Really, Sheryl burst on the music scene 2 years ago with that great video of people floating through the air.
Uh-huh.
She had sold millions of records. She's really done amazingly well. This record, or the video that we're seeing right now, is...
If it makes you happy.
It mixes together a soulful sound, a bluesy sound, and really the Rolling Stones type sound that she's put together that's really made this a record that's going to prove to people that she's here to stay.
Yeah, okay, well, that's good, because sometimes it's tough to come back with a second success right after the...
Well, the old saying is you have your whole life to make your first record and one year to make your next. And she's made a great record. This comes out in about 3 weeks.
Now, what I'm hearing you say, though, is, I mean, these are all proven artists, and they're not, like, really new names.
Well, it's very difficult. All the big guns come out at Christmas, so it's hard for the newcomers to kind of get their heads up and be noticed. But there are great new artists, like Amanda Marshall from Canada, Maxwell, who's like a young Marvin Gaye. And we've even put together a record called VH1 Crossroads, where we have our show, Crossroads, where we introduce a lot of new artists. So we put together a compilation record in October.
And what's this Wallflowers? You're excited about Wallflowers.
We love this band at VH1. Wallflowers, well, if you like Bruce Springsteen, Counting Crows, and the band.
That's kind of the sound?
Yes, you'll love the Wallflowers. They're led by Jacob Dylan, who is, Bob's son. But he doesn't need any help from Dad on this one.
So he makes it on his own. Is this the one that's Sixth Avenue Heartache?
Heartache, yes. This is the video we're watching right now.
All right. It's his son.
It's his son, and he's really...
Does Dad help him on it at all, or work on it with him?
Nothing. He's done it with his band, but a lot of great guest musicians. In fact, Adam Duritz from Counting Crows sings harmonies on this single, Sixth Avenue Heartache.
Okay, then a little bit later in the fall, we've got a lot of other stuff coming. I want to just run through it. You were just telling me a new one, Michael Bolton and Phil Collins.
Phil Collins, Michael Bolton, Tom Petty and Pearl Jam are out right now. You've got Whitney Houston coming out with another soundtrack. You've got Madonna's Evita soundtrack, Van Halen's greatest hits, Aerosmith, Journey's gotten back together. Just, it's going to be
a ton of new music coming
out. The big, big ammo coming out for Christmas, but a fun time to go in the record stores.
Absolutely. All right, John, thank you very much. And coming up next, other game shows give away lawn furniture and car wax, but now there's one that gets you out of debt. Find out about it when Good Morning America continues.
Now, Renee, since you have spent less than your opponents in the game of life, you get the honor of selecting our first guest.
Got something different for your sensitive teeth.
Well, you can take it back. My dentist wants me to use Sensodyne.
This is Sensodyne. Sensodyne with baking soda.
No pain. My mouth feels fresh and clean.
Sensodyne with baking soda. All you feel is fresh and clean.
21 years from now and 3,486 bowls of Quaker Instant Oatmeal later, David will be honored as NFL Player of the Year. In a short speech, he will say,
"Thanks, Mom."
Quaker Oatmeal. Oh, what those oats can do. When the game starts this early, you need real coffee. Folgers Coffee Singles. Real mountain-grown coffee and a real coffee filter for one freshly brewed cup. Folgers Coffee Singles, because real coffee makes real good mornings.
Last month, Publishers Clearinghouse surprised a winner in one state. Now they'll surprise a winner in every state. Starting October 7th, the Prize Patrol will surprise 50 winners in 50 states with prizes up to $100,000. Enter today and the winner could be you.
They're here. Champion Portland Summer Savings Specials are here now. For a limited time only, get a 96 Taurus for only $139 a month or a 96 Escort Sport for only $99.95. Too much? How about a 96 Aspire for an incredible $79.95? What's sporty? A 96 Mustang for only $249 a month or a 96 Thunderbird LX for just $239 a month. If you're thinking of getting a new car, the time is now. Don't miss these specials. Only at Champion Portland. Only for a limited time. Champion Portland, where we make the deal right for you.
Dole's attack ad, wrong again. President Clinton expanded the death penalty to drug kingpins. Nearly 40% more border agents to stop drugs. Record number of drug felons in federal prison. President Clinton expanded school anti-drug programs. Dole and Gingrich tried to cut them, voted against 100,000 police. Bob Dole even voted against creating a drug czar. President Clinton appointed a four-star general drug czar and is leading the fight to protect our children.
There's a new game show on television that may be a sign of the times. It is called Debt. It has sort of a cult following. Contestants who win the top prize have all their debts paid off. I don't know if it works for multimillionaires, but let's take a look.
Drowning in a sea of bills.
Then it's time to play Debt. The game show where three debt-laden Americans just like you compete to have us pay off all their bills and go home with nothing. And now, let's meet today's contestants.
I'm Deanna, and I'm in debt because I charge airline tickets to visit my family.
I'm Robert, and I'm in debt because I bought a condo that needs lots of repairs.
I'm Renee, and I'm in debt because I started my own tree farm business.
It's so campy. Now, we should say it's on Lifetime, right?
It looks like a joke.
I mean, yeah, it's so campy. It looks like a joke. It looks like something that they, one of those little parodies they do, like on Saturday Night Live, except it's real.
Hi, I'm Tammy, and I'm $10,000 in debt.
And you go home with nothing.
I could. Hi, I'm Elizabeth. I bought too much clothing last month, and I'm in debt for $12,000.
Why would you stand up and declare how silly you've been and how you've gotten yourself
to have your bills paid off?
Well, if it means you're going to get all your bills paid off, maybe you do it, you know?
And they're doing it in a happy-go-lucky way.
People have done silly things on
That's
TV.
Right.
Welcome to Debt, the show with contestants who know no shame.
But isn't it a little better than talking about how dysfunctional your family is in front of the whole world on a talk show?
Bingo. Right?
Talk about knowing no shame.
But didn't you ever watch Queen for a Day?
Yes.
Do you remember
Queen
that
for
show?
Day. How
I remember
would
growing
you
up,
like to be Queen for a day.
And they each gave, you know, the story.
The sad
of
story.
A sad
yep.
story of their woes. And you,
well,
and then everybody, there was like a little measure that
really?
They'd clap at the end,
yeah,
and we'd see
is
who.
Yeah, this the old days of TV.
Hi,
we were children.
I made stupid investments, and I'm $10,000. Actually, the latest, the latest figures show consumers in this country owe $384 billion.
Yeah.
So that show better have a large budget.
Galore.
We'll be back.
Congress will be there soon.
Time is on my side. Yes, it is. Time.
People today are living longer and healthier lives.
Yes, it
and at Nature Made, we like to think we've been a part
You're
of it.
Looking for good times.
As the makers of vitamin and mineral supplements that are recommended by pharmacists more than 1,000 times a day. Nature Made. Recommended by pharmacists. Made for a lifetime.
My dad has been my dentist since my first tooth has come in. This is the first toothpaste that he's ever sent me.
This is Tartar Control Mentadent with fluoride, baking soda, and peroxide. Mentadent helps stop tartar before it forms. Tartar Control Mentadent.
It has everything.
What's true about Bogus? The critics say it's completely enchanting, as good as gold, a great spirit lifter. Bogus is super entertainment, an absolute joy. Four stars, a classic, a masterpiece.
You're my best friend.
That will affect every emotion you possess. It's about laughter. It's about life. It's about time for Bogus, starring Whoopi Goldberg and Gerard Depardieu. Rated PG, starts Friday, September 6th.
To introduce new Quaker Quick and Hearty Oatmeal, we could try impressing you with important words. Words like revolutionary and breakthrough. We could try tempting you with other words like slow-cooked taste, hearty old-fashioned texture, and brown sugar cinnamon. But then, actions speak so much louder. Don't they? New Quaker Quick and Hearty. Oh, what those oats can do.
She wanted to remember the love they shared for butter, but cholesterol took away their passion until...
Now, live from the news station, News Watch 16.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Kim Supon. It is 8:25 Wednesday, September the 4th. A chlorine leak this morning at the Wyoming Valley Sanitary Authority caused some concern. Just before 6 this morning, a worker discovered a chlorine tank leaking. The valve was shut off immediately. The Sanitation Authority tells News Watch 16 nearby homes and workers weren't in any danger because the leak turned out to be a small one. The Wyoming Valley Sanitary Authority in Luzerne County is the same place where body parts were found in sewage vats several weeks ago. Somebody broke into a Unimart in Clinton County overnight, made off with about $100 and did hundreds of dollars in damage. The place is in Castaneda Township. Clinton County cops are trying to find the thief this morning after that Unimart to break in. Some angry parents are threatening to sue the Shamokin Area School District. They say conditions at the junior-senior high school aren't safe while renovation work is going on. Nearly 30 students have been suspended after walking out of classes on Friday and then again yesterday. Students and parents met with school officials at a meeting last night to complain. School officials vow Shamokin area is cleaner and safer than ever. Renovations there are not supposed to be finished until next summer. A court hearing over a Lackawanna County strip club will continue today. The owners of La Dolce Vita in Springbrook Township were in court yesterday fighting to keep the place open. Township leaders say the club is operating illegally. The Lackawanna County Club has already been subjected to a protest by neighbors and a police raid that cited the place for allowing nude dancing. A doctor accused of killing his friend 20 years ago has a date in court this morning. It's a hearing to find out if Dr. Stephen Scher will go to trial on charges he killed Martin Dillon. Scher has said Dillon tripped and accidentally shot himself while the two were hunting, but prosecutors aren't buying that, and we'll have more on the hearing today on Newswatch 16 at noon.
Dr. Scher, did you do?
Some veterans in Susquehanna County are reacting to the U.S. attacks in Iraq. They think the president did the right thing by ordering the assaults. Critical targets were not destroyed in the first missile attack on Iraq early yesterday, so last night another attack came. The attacks are to punish Saddam Hussein for his aggression in the Kurdish safe areas. Vets we spoke with say Mideast will always be threatened as long as Saddam Hussein's in office. 28 minutes after the hour, Noreen is in the backyard right now with a quick look at the forecast. Noreen?
Well, Kim, not one of the most pleasant days around, but we do need the rain. We've got about a tenth of an inch so far. Taking a look at the expanded radar, much of the state of Pennsylvania covered with rain. It's moving from south to north, so off and on rain, sprinkles, and drizzle during the day ahead. Right now, 66 degrees. Here's the forecast. A cloudy, gray day with off and on rain and sprinkles. The high 73 tonight, mainly cloudy, maybe a shower. The low 62. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy day. Maybe some sunshine, but the risk of a shower, the high 75. On Friday, cloudy with a chance for a shower or thundershower, the high in the upper 70s. By Saturday and Sunday, we could see some tropical rain and thundershowers from Hurricane Fran. Both days will have highs in the 70s, so take along the umbrella or the slicker. You'll need it today. Kim?
Thanks, Noreen. Jay?
Good morning, Kim, and good morning, everybody. At the ballparks overnight, the New York Yankees dropped a 10-9 decision to California. Scott Brosius opened the A's scoring with a first-inning long shot. The East-leading Yankees stay four games up on Baltimore and 6.5 on Boston. Jim Edmonds' home run to right field gave the Angels a 3-1 lead that held up for the balance of that game. California registered a 6-run fifth to put it away. California gets by the Orioles 10-2. The Mariners belt Boston 11-9. And here's the top four teams in this week's Super 16 high school football rankings. Number one, Valley View, followed by Berwick, Mount Carmel, and Wyoming area. And those are the sport headlines for right now.
All right, Jay, thanks a lot. Have a good one. That'll do it for us. We'll see you back here today on Newswatch 16 at noon. Until then, have a good day.
For my cold sore, my pharmacist recommended Herpesin L, not some ordinary lip balm.
Herpesin L prevents painful cracking, promotes healing, helps avoid infection, stops sunburn too.
Really creamy.
Herpesin L treats and protects cold sores three ways.
When pain strikes, go for the Flexol and get going again. In clinical tests, people suffering from pain confirmed that aloe vera-based Flexol penetrates deep to bring fast-acting, long-lasting relief. Flexol.
Don't miss the Super 16 Sports Final, Friday nights on Newswatch 16 at 11.
Good morning, America. I'm Charles Gibson.
Of the C.W. Morey School in Lowell, Massachusetts. Good morning, America!
Now, what was your name?
I'm sorry, I'm not a member of that class, and I'm sorry, I didn't mean to jump on their chance to say good morning, America. Nice to have them here. I'm Charles Gibson, as I was saying.
And I'm Dylan.
Before I was interrupted. Yes. And then I interrupted you.
And it's Wednesday, September 4th.
And we just before we interrupted the show, to go away to local news there to 23 minutes after the hour. We were talking about this new TV show called Debt, where people come on and happily, apparently, proclaim their debts.
And then they get them paid off.
And then they contest, and the winner gets their debts paid off. And just as we went to commercials or to local news, Spencer had such a great idea.
Well, actually, I said Congress should become a contestant, but it's funnier if the president goes on and says, "Hi, I'm Bill Clinton. I've got this big debt.
I've got the national debt.
I've got $200 trillion in debt. And we can have the television show pay off the national debt. It's all done.
There you go.
All done.
Yeah, I've always felt we should take television shows and apply them to national issues. I've always thought we should just give the Middle East crisis to Judge Wapner. He can decide the whole thing in 15 minutes. It's done.
Yep, yep.
Right? They walk out of there, everybody's happy.
Weather could be controlled by the Wizard of Oz.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway, welcome back to Good Morning America over here. we are going to be talking about the recurring story, of course, coming up, which is that U.S. ships in the Persian Gulf strike again at Iraqi installations, and we will get all the latest on that tense situation in just a moment.
Also ahead, new software games are coming to a computer near you this fall. There are offerings from big names such as Steven Spielberg. Yeah. Spielberg on computer, plus old favorites like the Pink Panther. Our computer editor, Gina Smith, is going to try out the best of a bunch just a little later in this half hour.
And also ahead, protecting your home. House Dr. Ron Hazelton will show you some of the innovative gadgets that you can get to kind of beef up your home security. Right now, though, we will get all the latest developments on Iraq and the other morning's news from Elizabeth Vargas. Hi, Elizabeth.
Hi. Thanks again, Joan. Hello again, everybody. Early today, the new U.S.-imposed fly zone went into effect in the sky south of Baghdad. Prior to that, a second round of missile strikes against Iraqi targets was intended to finish the job of yesterday's missile strike. The Pentagon said the missile's mission was to cripple Iraq's air defense system and make it safer for Allied pilots to patrol the new no-fly zone.
In the second strike that we had four targets. And after assessment of that restrike, it was the judgment of the commanders on the scene that the risk to our air crews and pilots was sufficiently reduced that Operation Southern Watch could proceed.
General Ralston said U.S. planes began surveillance of the new zone at noon local time, 5 o'clock Eastern time. For the latest developments on the situation in Iraq, the path of Hurricane Fran, and all the day's news events, tune into World News Tonight with Peter Jennings. In the meantime, new teachers, new classrooms, and new friends. Today is a big day for millions of young Americans, and for some New York junior high school students, it is especially exciting. But not everyone shares their enthusiasm. Here's ABC's Antonio Mora.
One red and one blue.
This year's back-to-school drill is different for Donia McDermott.
I need a calculator.
She is one of 50 seventh graders who are starting classes today at the Young Women's Leadership School in East Harlem. It is believed to be the first all-girls public school to open in the U.S. in more than two decades.
I felt it would be better if she'd concentrate more on academics if she didn't have the distraction of boys.
A lot of the boys act stupid, and the girls are more mature a lot, because they make jokes and stuff and things like that when it's not appropriate.
The school is founded on the premise, supported by numerous studies, that girls learn better when boys aren't in the classroom.
It's really about providing the conditions for learning so that the girls feel really comfortable and they feel empowered.
But this effort to raise girls' achievement is already under attack. Civil liberties groups have filed complaints insisting the school discriminates against boys and isolates the girls, that separate is inherently unequal.
We have rejected the notion that people can be denied admission based on immutable traits such as race, gender, or national origin.
But students here argue they should have a choice.
Some girls want to go to an all-girls private school, but they don't have the money to go to an all-girls private school.
And if this school succeeds, the hope is that others like it will open across the country. Antonio Mora, ABC News, New York.
And finally this morning, here's a little new math to mull over with your breakfast this morning. Cray Research has found the biggest known prime number. A prime number is a number such as 3 or 5 that can only be divided by itself and by the other number 1. The new biggest known prime number is obtained by multiplying the number 2 by itself more than 1.25 million times and then subtracting 1. Written out, it would fill 12 pages of your morning newspaper. Much smaller prime numbers are used in computer security codes. Spencer, I'm sure that you'll be employing this one with your computer security code.
2 to the 1.25 millionth power, yeah.
It'll only take you, like, all day long to log on.
Exactly. And let's hope it doesn't take that long to track this storm, Elizabeth. Hurricane Fran becoming a dangerous hurricane now, moving just north of the Bahama Islands, but dealing a hurricane blow to the Bahamas. In fact, hurricane warning is in effect for the Bahamas today, and a hurricane watch for much of the South Atlantic U.S. coast as the storm continues its northwestward movement, packing highest sustained winds of 115 miles per hour. On this course, it'll probably make landfall late Thursday night or early Friday morning around the South Carolina coast. Meanwhile, heavy rainfall in the east today, not associated with Hurricane Fran. Afternoon thunderstorms could be heavy, rolling out of the southern Rockies into the southern plains, and it'll be damp and cool in the Pacific Northwest. That's a look at the national weather. Here's a look at the weather where you are.
Temperatures now in most locations are in the 60s. We do have a cloudy gray day with off and on rain showers and sprinkles, the high 73. Mainly cloudy tonight, the risk of a shower, the low 62.
And this weather report has been brought to you by Sandoz Nutrition. You will fall for the great new computer games coming out in the months ahead, and we'll show you as Good Morning America continues.
Trapped here. If Jared captures this power, he will be...
Now, here's some welcome news. It's not age that slows most of us down. It's usually not eating right. New Resource helps guarantee you get the nutrition you need to be your best every day. Improve your diet. Improve your life with New Resource, the liquid nutritional food. And here comes more good news. Resource is the only nutritional drink with fresh fruit flavors and no fat. Only from Resource.
Dear Robert, it was great talking to you. You know I've had trouble sleeping lately, so I went out, like you said, and got Unisom. I don't like the idea of taking something, but even the pharmacist said Unisom's not habit-forming, so not to worry. Anyway, I wanted to tell you I got, a wonderful night's sleep.
The best in weeks. And I feel lucky to have a son like you. Love, Mom.
So, Ann, you are a lab technician at a Columbia hospital.
Yeah, well, we're really more than just a hospital.
Oh, okay. What are you then?
Columbia is a consortium of healthcare professionals. We touch on virtually every facet of our patients' medical needs.
So if I get hurt, I need to say, quick, rush me to a consortium of healthcare professionals.
Exactly. I'm kidding you.
Oh, neat.
Oh, thanks.
Chemistry.
Yeah.
If you want full office suite power at a word processor price, look no further than Corel Word Perfect Suite. Corel Word Perfect Suite includes an exceptionally intelligent word processor, an award-winning spreadsheet, amazing presentation graphics, plus business graphics and utilities, hundreds of fonts and thousands of clip art images. Corel Word Perfect Suite delivers office suite power at a word processor price.
Good Morning America's computer line is brought to you by Corel WordPerfect.
All right, dolphins in outer space, they're coming your way when the new crop of computer games lands on store shelves this fall. There's plenty to choose from, and here to help make the right choices is our computer editor, Gina Smith. Hi, Gina.
Good morning, Joan. Now, there is a whole new world out there as computer games explore some really uncharted territory. We're talking clay kingdoms, cartoon creatures that think, and even one very familiar panther. Here's what you'll be playing in the months ahead.
No one's sneakier than this cat. He's a master at disguise, as you'll see in the Pink Panther's Passport to Peril, coming out in October. The famous feline's mission, to fight for world peace.
This mission could involve danger.
Dangerous danger? Quite possibly.
From the Great Pyramids to Stonehenge, you guide the panther on this multicultural spy adventure, meeting bizarre characters and learning some serious facts about history and culture as you uncover clues to a safer world. But there's no peace to be found in Toonstruck, a title packed with star power. Starring Christopher Lloyd as Drew Blank and other well-known actors, this zany CD-ROM will feature live video and animation when it hits shelves in November. Drew is a cartoon animator stuck in a world of his own creation, and only you can get him out by outsmarting some pretty wacky beings and creating lots of havoc along the way.
Oh, dear.
Different worlds await in November if you visit The Neverhood, one of the first games from director Steven Spielberg's software company. You're the hero in this clay-animated kingdom. The unique look comes from the 3 tons of clay used to make this fantasy world. Your quest here is to protect the realm from evil by your cunning at problem-solving. If navigating the perils of space is more your style, take a look at the next generation in LucasArts Star Wars games. It's Jedi Knight, Dark Forces 2, due out next year. In this 3D action game, you'll take on the evil Empire. Get nasty with your lightsaber, and defend the honor of the light side with all the same drama of the famous movie series. And in this game of celestial adventure coming out in December, you play a dolphin, one of the smartest creatures on the space station Blue Star. It's the 21st century, and Blue Star is a futuristic think tank. Together with human scientists, like this one played by actor LeVar Burton, you're trying to tame the station's supercomputer before it takes over your world. It's run amok, as computers sometimes do.
These are really amazing. First of all, price. What are the prices?
Yeah, hasn't the animation and video gotten a lot better than
made?
Last year when we did this. Like last year, we're talking $40 to $60 per CD, although none of these are out yet, but that's what we're expecting.
Okay, I asked you before, can these be played on any computer?
See, Jen, this is what is ironic, and you'd never expect this, but games and entertainment software really require the most powerful computer at all. I wouldn't even try to touch any of these titles without at least 16 megabytes of memory, a fast Pentium processor, a quadruple speed CD-ROM, and very good sound capabilities and stickers.
So you have to have a really heavy-duty computer in order to play this kind
of... Yeah, even more so than for home office applications.
When I hear the names George Lucas, Steven Spielberg, I mean, it sounds like we're getting interactive movies. Is that what we're kind of approaching?
We're certainly seeing Hollywood production values, and what remains to be seen is, can these companies make the products look as good as Hollywood but still be as fun as a very good game?
Because that's been the challenge. They haven't been able to.
They have to do both
to
make a good game. Absolutely.
All right, Gina, thank you.
Nice to see you, Jeff.
And coming up next, House Dr. Ron Hazelton has new ways to protect your home and family when Good Morning America continues here on ABC.
After 25 years comes the triumphant return of one of the theater's most powerful events. It's a spiritual experience that will move you, a musical experience you'll never forget. It's the greatest story ever told. Jesus Christ Superstar, the show that rocked the world, featuring the magnificent music of Andrew Lloyd Webber and the haunting lyrics of Tim Rice, starring from the original cast, Ted Neely as Jesus. On stage September 15th at the FM Kirby Center. Tickets available now.
If the fine print in some insurance policies confuses you, Thompson Insurance in Clark Summit recommends the Universal Security Policy from Continental Casualty Company, one of the CNA insurance companies. No confusing fine print, just easy to understand language that explains what protection you have for your auto, your home, RV, furs, and more. The Universal Security Policy. Call Thompson Insurance in Clark Summit at 587-2026.
Mattress Man is red hot with the year's hottest buys. Get the lowest prices on top quality bedding from America's best manufacturers. Names like Sealy, Simmons, Serta, and King Coil, plus hot on-the-spot rebates. 20 for twin, $40 for full, $60 for queen, and $80 for kings. Free delivery setup and removal of old bedding. When you add it up, there's just one place to get your new mattress. You'll love us in the morning. For the nearest Mattress Man discount sleep center, call 1-800-MATTMAN.
Tune in to the Rosie O'Donnell Show every day and catch some of your favorite celebrities in action.
Moi, mi, moi, mi, moi.
And if you don't laugh at least once while watching the Rosie O'Donnell Show, you'll receive a full money-back guarantee.
Kidding!
Grab a front row seat with your favorite stars next time as Rosie welcomes Golden Girl Estelle Getty, plus international actress and model Isabella Rossellini, and From All My Children, soap star Robin Madsen.
There you have it.
Finally, something different in daytime. The Rosie O'Donnell Show.
This morning at 10 after Regis and Kathy Lee.
I don't have to tell you that Americans are worried about crime these days, and thus small wonder the home security business is booming, homeowners getting increasingly sophisticated about their security systems. And our house doctor, Ron Hazelton, recently returned from the International Security Expo, where he found some new ways to protect your home. This is neat stuff that you found.
Yeah, it really is, and it reflects a trend now in home security that we're concerned about, not only keeping burglars out, but keeping our family safe. This is a product here called Baby Watch, and actually it allows you to keep an eye on your child from almost anywhere in your house. It has a camera, which mounts to a bassinet or a crib. It can be mounted on a wall. And then this monitor right here. Now, this monitor can be anywhere in your home. As a matter of fact, you can have several of these. And the idea is you can simply keep an eye not only on what your child is doing, but you can also hear what they're doing.
And it's small enough you could pick it up and carry it around.
No wires between the two. It is wireless, so no wires connecting each of these two components, but they do have to be plugged into an electrical outlet.
All right, what's behind me here? It looks like you've brought a more traditional home security system, but this one you say you can do yourself?
Yeah, this is a good low-cost wireless system, and you could install this yourself, or you could have a professional do it for you. What I like about this is it's modular. You can buy what you need, starting with a control panel, either one that mounts on a wall just like this, or one that sits on a table and simply plugs into an outlet. Then, of course, you'd want to add some sensors. We've got one on the door right up here. Over here, we've got one on the window. Now, that means when the door or window is open, those will go off. Up here, we've got a motion detector, which can sort of see an intruder move through a room. And then, of course, that would set the alarm off. You can also get these modules down here, which plug into any receptacle. And then, of course, a lamp cord would plug into this. So what happens is, when we open the door here and set off our alarm, it also turns on all the lights that are on those modules. They flash on and off. You could have 5 or 10 lights doing that, including your porch light or ceiling lights.
There's enough bings and bongs that you think you're at a sale in Kmart.
Right. Invasion of the Ant People or something like that.
Right. Now, this is interesting. This is a clock that's not a clock, right?
This is a clock. It is a clock. It actually is a working clock, but it's also, I'm pointing this at you right now, is a television camera. This will feed an image
into that clock?
Right into this clock. It'll feed an image to the, it's right in here, right in this strip.
Probably
it'll feed an image into a television set or into a VCR. People are using these to keep an eye on their babysitters to make sure that their children are getting proper care.
Well, and also, if somebody came in, if you were videotaping or something, and somebody came in and tried to steal the television set, they'd be.
It has been used for that. And people suspect someone might be coming into their apartment, they'll set this up, turn their VCR on, leave, and they've got the evidence that they need.
See, don't show that to the ABC bosses.
Suspicious air about us.
You show that to the ABC bosses, we'll get rid of the cameras and just have clocks around here.
If you see that in somebody's office, you watch what you say, Charlie.
All right. Now, this one's interesting. Yeah, this is for outside the home,
this
right?
is for outside. There are times when you might want to look and see what's going on. It's like you hear a strange noise, an alarm goes off. You don't want to go out there. Mm-hmm. This camera is completely weatherproof, can be mounted anywhere outside. It's wireless. It'll transmit a picture to any TV set. Just has a receiver right here.
Does it see in the dark?
It does see in the dark. And to prove that point, look in my black box right here and tell me what you see.
A black box. I don't see anything.
Nothing, right? Completely dark. Now, this has its own built-in infrared light source. I'm going to put this down in here. Look at the monitor over here now and see if you can see what's in there.
Oh. Thank goodness you didn't put a French postcard in there. All right.
So, anyway, that's really handy.
Yeah. So you mount this on the house, and it just shows you what's going on outside the house.
It does.
Do you have to sit in front of the television set all the time watching what's going on outside your own house?
If you have nothing better to do, you can do that. Or you can just wait for some noise or some kind of an alarm to sort of trigger you that you might want to take a look at this and see
what's
out there.
Well, that's true. If an alarm goes off, then you can tell outside what's happening.
Yeah.
All right. We take a commercial break. When we come back, Ron's going to show you some more security gadgets when Good Morning America continues.
Any restaurant can feed you a meal, but what if you wanted more? Well, the Mark II Family Restaurants have come to the rescue. Every day from 11 a.m. until 3 p.m., the Mark II offers up their gigantic soup and salad bar free with any sandwich or entree. Enjoy assorted fruits, salads, vegetables, and two different soups daily. At the Mark II Family Restaurants, no one ever walks away hungry.
You're changed.
Or broke. The best dollar value in town, the Mark II Family Restaurants.
Listen, can you hear that? If you listen very carefully, you can hear the sound of footsteps. The race for the cure grows every year, and behind each pair of footsteps, there are hearts beating and faces smiling. Won't you join the race? Add your footsteps to the race against breast cancer. Every step taken is a step closer to the cure.
From WNEP TV 16, here's the forecast for your neighborhood.
Early
early today, temperatures in most locations are in the 60s. And we do have a cloudy gray day with off and on showers and sprinkles, high 73. Cloudy tonight with the risk of a shower. Tomorrow offers a mainly cloudy day with a chance for a shower. On Friday, cloudy with a chance for a shower or thunder shower. For Saturday and Sunday, tropical rain and thunder showers from Hurricane Fran. Highs both days in the 70s.
Good morning, everybody. Here's the bulletin board for Wednesday morning. The girls' gymnastic team will sponsor a car wash Saturday from 9 to 4 at the Walmart in Scenic Grove. A child identification day will take place Saturday from noon to 5 at the Lehman Township Municipal Building. And St. Mary's Church of St. Clair will hold a craft show and a flea market Saturday from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Have a pleasant day.
Now on the newest in home security systems, the house doctor Ron Hazelton with us, and you showed us some interesting ones before. This one, I gather, talks to you and shows you where the problem is in the house, right?
Right. Like the X10 Pro, this is the first system we saw over here. It has all the basic abilities plus some additional ones. And this one will talk to you. We've got a sensor hooked up to our window right here. Let's raise the window up, close it back down. Now this is going to set off an alarm. It'll take a little while here. Sometimes it has to cycle through here. But in a moment here, you're going to hear the alarm come on. Then you're going to hear a digitized voice that's going to tell us where the intrusion occurred, the fact that it was an intrusion. There's our signal.
Right.
Now listen for the voice. It'll say intrusion.
Intrusion. Sensor 1-0.
Okay, so it tells us, A, that it's an intrusion and not a fire. And it also tells us where it took place.
Well, it was saying on here, living room window. It was just scanning.
Yes, if you're here and you can see this panel, you can do that. If you're in another part of the house, you might just hear that. Now, you can also use your telephone with this system to turn this on and off from virtually any place in your home, any phone in your home, or any telephone in the world. And you can also use this system to as a sort of a panic button. If you're in bed, you hear a strange noise, you can pick this up, hit a particular code, and it will... this back on for you here. I'm going to turn it back on now. And it would notify the central monitoring station.
So you can hook it up with a monitor somewhere else. This man, or some man just like him, is sitting at a system like this, and he can tell where the problem is in your house.
Most experts agree that the best security systems are those that notify some kind of central monitoring system, and this is sort of a typical station right here. Up until very recently, all the information that the operator might get would be maybe your name and address and that there was either a fire or a burglary. Now, this is a new system developed by DSC, which not only sends that information, but also gives you a picture. This comes from television cameras that would be mounted inside your home.
But that's getting pretty expensive when that happens.
Well, this adds about $500 to the basic system to have these cameras in here. And what it does is it helps the operator verify this is a legitimate false alarm. So they can tell it's
a legitimate call and not a false alarm.
Right.
Right.
Right. So that they know it's not a pet and, in fact, is someone coming through the window. It's very useful in medical emergencies when someone has fallen, they've injured themselves, or they're ill, because not only can the operators see who's calling here and see how much distress they're in, but if you have the right equipment, they can actually carry on a two-way conversation with that person.
All right, very final one. And this one's neat. This is sort of a concept that I'd never thought of.
Well, this is, you know, most alarm systems simply send out a notice that there's something wrong. This one actually fights back. This was developed in England, just been introduced to the U.S. And you might want to have this in a room, let's say, that has valuable records, if you have a home office or maybe a collection or jewelry or something like that. What happens is when a burglar comes in here and trips the sensor, there's a powerful smoke generator that will fill this room with smoke in a matter of seconds, making it impossible for him to see and giving him no choice but to get out of the room. I'm going to show you. Here comes our burglar right now. He's entering the room. We've triggered off the smoke generators. Now you can see in just about, less than 10 seconds, this room is completely filled up. Now, this is non-toxic smoke.
You okay in there?
Completely non-toxic smoke and leaves no residue when it evaporates.
How can he see to get out?
That's the point.
he's trapped in there. You
set this up so that he sees the smoke coming toward him and he can escape.
Oh.
Most people are not going to hang around to find out if it's toxic or not.
All right. Interesting stuff, Ron. As always, thank you very much. They're coming at us. There's more smoke coming every minute. If our cameras can still see through the smoke, we'll take a commercial break, come back, close the show in just a moment. I should mention America Online subscribers can chat with Ron Hazelton about home improvement today at 12 noon Eastern Time. Type in the keyword GMA, and Ron will be sitting there next to his computer to tell you all about it. We'll be back in just a moment.
If you experience vaginal dryness, now there's new Vagisil Intimate Moisturizer. It's like bringing back your own natural moisture. Just a few clear drops replace your body's own natural moisture, relieve dryness, and it's smooth as liquid silk, never greasy. Developed with a woman gynecologist, Vagisil Intimate Moisturizer has natural aloe, and it's safe to use every day. It's like bringing back your own natural moisture with new Vagisil Intimate Moisturizer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Boscov's Fashion Trio. This week, singing the praises of Zipline, Misty Harbor, and American Bazaar all-weather coats for the spectacular price of $79.99. Save $100 on every one of these fashionable coats for missies and petites. Act Two, only $49.99 for an incredible group of Misty Harbor and Herman K. active and stadium jackets, appearing now at all Boscov's.
There's lots of stars, fun, and excitement ahead on the next Live with Regis and Kathy Lee. First, find out why there's no one like Winona Judd. Plus, later this week, from Melrose Place, lovely Lisa Rinna drops in. And pet expert Warren Eckstein stops by. He'll trot out the world's smallest dogs. Then Sherman Hensley's back in prime time. Find out why he's on Good Behavior. All on the next Live with Regis and Kathy Lee.
This morning at 9.
Good morning, everybody. Well, the weekend is just around the corner, and here's what's happening. You're invited to an Afghan party Saturday at 6 p.m. at the Seelyville Fire Hall. Take the family to an Irish festival Saturday from noon to 9 p.m. at the RCA Picnic Grounds in Cole Township. And handmade crafts will be featured Saturday from 9 a.m. to 2 at the Calvary United Methodist Church in Berwyn.
Is brought to you by Columbia Healthcare.
Did you see that last segment?
Yes.
Ron and I were smoking. Spencer, final look at the weather.
Well, Hurricane Fran is smoking right now too, Charlie. She's bearing down on the northern Bahamas, headed towards the South Atlantic coast, packing highest winds of 115 miles per hour, may make landfall by late tomorrow night or early Friday morning.
All right, and tomorrow on Good Morning America, actress Whoopi Goldberg joins us. She's got a new movie out.
And then on Friday, I should mention, we're going to be out in our own backyard. We're going to do the whole show from Central Park, which is just outside our studios. See you tomorrow. Take care.
You know what's amazing? You need a degree to be a lawyer, a license to be a plumber, a permit to get married, but you don't need that stuff to be a mentor. To be a mentor, you just need a few hours each week to help a kid grow up happier. You can coach, read, do homework, or just talk. To be a mentor, you just need to be a good person. And you didn't think you were qualified. Children first.
On our next show, love has kept them together.
Captain and Tennille perform live.
And some stars are sitting pretty.
Others are sweating bullets.
We'll tell you who we think will be bringing home an Emmy.
And who will be going home alone.
Carol and Marilyn, real friends.
Today on ABC Daytime.
What is a townie? Someone who believes in the institution of marriage.
I know this is a really emotional week for you, but you gotta pick your spots, honey.
My wedding day will be the happiest day of my life. My wedding day. Okay, better now.
Townies, ABC Wednesdays in 2 weeks.
This is the new TV Guide. Just open it up, and boom, you're there. Inside the Emmys issue, it's television's biggest night. Who's nominated? More importantly, who's wearing what? And predictions for who's going home a winner. When you want to be there, get inside TV Guide.
Got questions about film processing? You won't get answers from a Dropbox. So break out of there
and come to Phase Drugs. Our photo specialists will answer your questions and personally handle your film. So break the silence and talk to us at Phase.
Here's a nice picture of you at the beach.
Still got the body of a 20-year-old, don't I? Why?
At Faze, every day is free day. Get a free mini album and your choice of a free second set of prints or a free roll of Faze film.
It's the back page. This week's Best Buys at 286.
A 94 Ford Escort LX sedan, $69.95. A 95 Dodge Neon sedan, $69.95. And a 94 Buick Skylark, $95.50.
Catch a back page Best Buy now. Special purchase. Fleet buyouts. Repos and more. Economy. Midsize. Luxury. All purpose. No one can beat a back page deal. Because no one can beat 286.
And now, the latest forecast from the News Watch 16 Weather Center. Stay tuned for updates.
It's Live with Regis and Kathy Lee. Today, we get a performance from one of country's greatest. Winona sings us a song from her latest album. And he went for the gold and got it. Olympic wrestler Kurt Angle shows us his moves. Plus, we get a visit from actor Eric Roberts. All next on Live. Now, here are Regis Philbin and Kathy Lee Gifford.
Thank you. Hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. Thank you very much. Nice to see you. Wednesday, September 4th, 1996. A little cloudy out there, but going to be okay. Well, look at you. Is this a little winter look, or?
I'm the mother of a first grader. Alert the media.
What was that like? Was he scared?
No.
He was looking forward to it.
Get away from me.
Yes.
Oh, no. It's just that, you know, nothing prepares you for it, even though when they start school at 2. There's something about the fact that they go to first grade. A moment of silence, please. Anyway, but we had, of course, at our house, nothing could be normal. You can't just, like, go off to first grade. All three dogs had to get skunked before you can go off to first grade. You know, they have these collars that they wear that keep, you know, they're, like, invisible in fences to keep the dogs in the area that they're supposed to be. Well, for some reason this morning, I don't know what happened, but they weren't on. And Frank's taking Cody to first grade and getting in the car, and he hears this commotion. They're down in the area they're not supposed to be, and the three of them, Regis, Chardonnay, and Chablis, have a little skunk cornered. Unfortunately, Chardonnay has her nose where the sun don't shine, and now Chardonnay cannot, I don't think she can come in the house for the next year and a half. Have you ever smelled a dog that just got skunked right in the face?
Pretty bad.
I'll change 50,000 diapers before I'd rather talk to a dog that just had a skunk.
Why don't we do that on the show? Let's get him or her de-skunked out on the show.
Remember?
Is there a certain person who does that?
I don't know. Well, Warren Eckstein, I suppose. But I wouldn't have those dogs if it weren't for Warren Eckstein. You're supposed to dip them in tomato juice.
Oh, no. Really?
Yeah. If anybody has a surefire cure for dogs that got skunked, could you just fax us today, please? Because that season, and I
kind of like skunked in tomato juice or dipped in tomato juice. That's fun.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Something to look forward to go home today.
Meanwhile, the dog is there smelling up the house, I'll bet. On the outside. They got her outside, right?
Well, all three of them got skunked, Reach.
Oh, my gosh.
All three.
You're going to have a big smell.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. But anyway, so it's a big day at our house.
So anyway, Cody, first grade is a big time.
And Cass finally learned to swim yesterday, so that's one of your fears. You know, you just don't rest until those water wings come off, and then you really can't rest anyway. Why did I have children? Ay, ay, ay.
I was out yesterday looking for, you know, still looking for the apartment for JJ and her three roommates.
Are you the only parent that's involved in
this
search?
Well, I'm the only one living here in New York City, I have that honor.
Mm-hmm.
So we did find two. Oh, we went into a building, yesterday afternoon, and the guy says to me, Frank Gifford lived here. I said, yeah, sure. it's the building where Frank, you know, the last.
On Lincoln. Yeah.
So we went down there, we looked at a place, and we said to the guy, is this okay for four, you know, occupants, four girls? Young women, no problem. So then we went to another place and saw another place that looked even a little bit better, but it wasn't exactly in the middle of the mainstream of life here in New York. But so we decided, well, let me go down and get JJ. So I drive down to 50th and 6th Avenue.
Oof, oof, what is that, working a half a mile? Oof.
What a wise guy. Now, it doesn't sound like much, and that's why I did it, because she only got a half hour off,
you know? Gotcha.
So I speed down there, and of course, I get on 50th Street, and there is no movement again on 50th Street.
Gridlock.
15 minutes to get down to 6th Avenue. You know why? The MTV Awards are on tonight, and they got some rock and roll band on the
playing
roof.
Playing in the street. Or
playing on top of the marquee of Radio City Musical. Bang, and a boom, and a bing, and everyone's looking. Traffic stopped.
Oh, is it Smashing Pumpkins?
Yeah, something like that. gets in the car, take her over to the one place. She liked that a lot. Let's go back to the other building, mm-hmm. you know.
Yeah.
And we go back there, and I said, look, I'm going to park the car here, and you guys go in and look.
What? Haven't you learned your lesson about parking those cars?
No, I found a car, oh. 18 quarters in, you know.
Oh, okay.
They went upstairs. I found a little store right down the street here, iced coffee. Oh, God, that felt good, you know, because by 4 o'clock, I'm beginning to fade. So I go in there, get a nice coffee, and there are little chairs and tables sitting outside, and so I found one all alone, three chairs and a table. I sat down on one chair with the little column blocking the sun from me. Boy, I said, you know, it's so amazing here in New York City how your life can change in an instant. You find a little cove, something nice happens to you. You love being here in New York.
A little refuge.
Yes, mm-hmm. And I sat there, and the world was going by out on the sidewalk, and I'm in the shade, and I got my iced coffee, and I'm sipping it. And I hear a voice say, is this chair taken?
The one you're in?
No. The other two vacant ones. Well, I said, but of course I'd sit down. This woman sat down. I said, well, I'm gonna enjoy this coffee. I don't care if Attila the Hun sits there. I'm going to enjoy this.
It's my moment.
My moment. She says, how do you like going to war?
She wants to talk Iraq.
Every time we have an election, we go to war. Right, lady, right. I'm trying to suck down this coffee now so I can get out of here. You know what I mean?
Now it's not tasting
so good. No.
Yeah. Well.
Well, she says, I'm going to see a movie. Well, what am I supposed to say? Not say anything?
What are you going to see?
I said, what are you going to see? Hey, I'm a professional talk show host.
You can talk to anybody.
I can handle myself out there. You think just in front of the camera I can talk? What are you going to see? She says, walking and talking. I said, I hear it's a pretty good movie. I never heard of it before. I'm faking my way through it just like I faked my way through this.
Walking and talking, one of those artsy ones.
Huh? So anyway, the coffee gave me indigestion. I had heartburn. Finally, they came out and... Oh, so in the building again, this time the guy that showed us the apartment has vanished. There's somebody else there. No, you can't have four occupants in this apartment. So it was all a waste of time. Anyway, took her back, and that's my story.
I'm exhausted. The search...
Oh, no, I think the other place, yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Isn't it funny, yours just going off to first grade, I'm looking for the apartment to after graduation. It's life goes on. How about that war, she says.
Was she for the war or against the war?
Well, she was disappointed we were in a war, but she claims that every time we get close to an election, somehow we get involved in a war.
But it's every time that Saddam Hussein gets in trouble domestically, he makes his forays into
And then we have to go correct it.
Yeah.
And there's strike two, the Post says, and that was a terrific headline because the news says strike two, two. Mm. And Newsday said, make Saddam pay.
I love the way President Bush used to say his name, Saddam.
That
Saddam wouldn't be prudent.
We're going to kick that Saddam out of there.
Well, apparently he did that because it really irked Saddam Hussein the way he said Saddam. So he said
it like that. I think he said it like that because that's the only way he could say it.
No. Quite an intelligent man, Reach.
Sometimes you have a Texas accent and it just comes out that way.
No, he knew that Saddam didn't like it.
Hey, that's right. You're a close personal friend, so why am I arguing?
Exactly.
The only one you don't know in the whole world is Saddam.
I spent a weekend with him in the Hamptons once.
It wasn't much.
Reach, there's some. One of the newspapers talks about might be USA Today, talks about how he's living up to his name. I think it might be on the front pages. In Arabic, Saddam means the one who confronts.
Ah, see, they named him right.
And or else he's living up to his name. You wonder what came first.
Yeah. I think probably the name came first.
Exactly. Then did he say to himself, I must live up to my name? Or?
I don't know. I haven't been there.
For 59 years, that's exactly what he's been doing despite hurting his own nation and others in a troubled part of the world. So I thought I'd just, you know. Saddam Hussein's mother could not have named him better, it starts out.
All right, good.
So what does Regis mean, king?
What's it a... Regis, excuse me, you're absolutely right. And you were talking about your dinner party the other night.
Yes.
And we have a calligrapher here from... Was this the lady that we talked to? Does Jill Boone ring a name?
Yes, we spoke to Jill
Boone. All right,
well,
that's the lady, and she says, I enjoyed the conversation this morning during trivia. Hope you enjoyed your geography lesson about the Florida Keys. She was the lady from the Florida Keys, and she's a calligrapher. And so she made me my own card.
I love it.
And I'm not going to be... I'm going to have it with me wherever I go.
You know what? You should have had that in front of you,
right
sucking on your iced coffee yesterday.
That's
right. She would not have bothered you because that would have said a king.
She made you one, too.
Ooh.
Court jester.
I like that. I like that a lot. I've been called a lot worse, so I'll take it.
But thank you very much, Jill. It's very nice of you.
I still don't know how long the trip is, but remember, we
you could have said that to us. Let's see, what else? So I watched a little tennis last night. Gee, Monica Seles was really odd. I've never seen somebody dominate a game the way she did last night.
She's still grunting like crazy?
She's got a double grunt now.
A double grunt, that's
right. Now, listen, we know and we love Monica Seles, but she's got the double grunt, which is enough to intimidate you right off the bat. It used to be, now it's, You meet a woman with a double grunt, you want to... She was great. Power. Boom.
She was amazing.
Oh,
and yet, you know, she's been here at our show, and she's just the loveliest.
She is. She really is. But she is so focused, so concentrated. I don't even think she knows she's grunting. She is so concentrated into that game, you know what I'm saying, that she just really was on the money last night. Wow.
I don't want
shots.
My kids to go into any professional sports, but if they were going to.
Tennis?
I would want Cody to play tennis.
Well, I thought it was golf.
Takes too long.
Does that? Well, some of these matches go on forever, but last night's were real quick. And Sampras.
And I like the fact that we could go to a tennis game and just sit there. You know, as we get older,
well,
golf courses are going to be a little
right.
rough. They don't have, you know, wheelchair things, you know, as.
That's right. If he goes into golf, you got to walk that whole course if you want to be Tiger Cody, we can call him.
Oh, gosh, was that Tiger Woods? What a story.
You know, I'm going to tell you the story. When we first went out to Los Angeles and we sang with Doc Severinsen's band, that means Johnny was still on the air in his last year. That was about 6 years ago.
Yes.
We all went out there. Remember that, Gilman? So I pick up the Los Angeles Times, and there's a story about this teenage phenomena, Tiger Woods.
Yes.
About 14, 15 years old, whatever he was, and I said, wow, this is some story, but unfortunately, Gelman didn't know golf, and so, you know, we couldn't book him. But I said to myself, I'm going to remember this name, because they're really saying this kid is going to be great, and sure enough,
well, he was beating eight-year-olds when he was three. I mean, this is truly a phenomenal story.
So now he is all grown up, but on the circuit and doing just fabulous. Gelman wants to...
Thank you.
Gilman, never interrupt us when we're in the opening.
I understand.
You know your place. It's over there. In fact, you're a little too close today.
It's my normal spot.
You know, he's missing his sofa.
What has he got?
Yeah, Mrs. Gifford, if you take your dog and rub it down with breadcrumbs soaked in lemon juice. Hey, this sounds pretty good. Lemon juice is... Then dip the dog in tomato juice. You'll have V8 juice. The bread absorbs the odor and the tomato takes it away. Say hi to Regis for me. Scott, I think it's, you know, it's
Markey.
Markey. Thank
Makes
you.
Sense.
Markley, Travadier, Rhode Island. Thank you.
Gilman again.
Hope Frank's at home listening to all this.
Gilman never approached the desk without saying, may I? I'm telling you the truth. Walking around like you're an equal. Stand over there.
Mix 1 tablespoon of bleach per gallon of water and bathe animal. Something not to get in the... Oh, be careful.
Be careful,
Be sure not to get it in their eyes, yes. Yeah. Okay, that's from
I could just
Pat
see you rubbing these three dogs down with the breadcrumbs and lemon juice and then into the tomato juice.
Another one, wow.
And that's the last one.
Thank you. If you'd like to descent your dog, try a mixture of vinegar and baking soda. Mix it into a paste and rinse it. Then lather ivory dish soap to kill the vinegar odor. It worked for my dog about 3 years ago. Do not do this in the house, for the scent lingers for weeks. Isn't that the truth? Last time Cody got skunked, last time Shardy got skunked, it was when Cody was born, and she just got rid of it, and that was 6 years ago. So, and here
really?
We go again.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
It takes a long time, huh?
And you want to be sweet to your dogs. You want to kiss them on the face and right on the lips, but
no
only
more
next time would kiss Chardonnay
no
today.
No more, yeah. All right, tomorrow on Live, Ms. Hospital Corners.
Hey, this is big.
You ask, who's Ms. Hospital
Corners? Oprah had JFK Jr. We've got Ms. Hospital Corners.
She is a bed-making champion. And
she's
I guess
been with us before, unless it's a new champ.
So this is a new champ, and she's going to demonstrate her stuff, I guess. Are we going to, Kathy and I, going to make beds?
Yes.
We're going to make a bed as opposed to her making a bed, is that it? Kathy, Kathy doesn't make beds, Gelman.
Excuse me.
She sleeps in them. You don't want to break a nap.
I am an expert bed maker.
Okay, we'll take her on tomorrow, okay? Miss Hospital Corners? Claudia Cohen, behind the scenes of the MTV Music Video Awards.
Is that going to be a sight tonight?
I love the way those people dress for that award show.
You know, Reach, they used to ask us every year. They've given up.
Two squares like us going out there, we would be stoned to death. They probably want to skunk us or something, you know?
Uh-oh, thank you.
Gelman, I'm trying to get through the show.
I'm sorry.
Former Days of Our Lives star and now one of the newest members of Melrose Place, Lisa Rinna.
Rinna.
It's Kathy Lee. To absolutely get rid of the skunk odor, wash your dog with a solution of water and Mazengil's douche. Incidentally, the name of this particular douche is No Foolin'.
No, Mazengil douche. And then they're saying,
who cares?
I can just see Frank now going to our pharmacy and.
Hey, Frank, what'll you have? Give me some of that douche.
Mazengil douche. It's for the dogs.
Yeah. Yeah, sure, Frank. Then when Frank leaves, who knows what they'll say.
Mix hydrogen peroxide and baking soda. All right, these are all good ideas. I thank you, everybody. Thank you.
No more faxes. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
All right, Lisa, film credits include the 1984 film Police Academy. Mm. What star of the films Three Men and the Baby and Cocoon appeared with Lisa Rinna?
Rinna.
Lisa Rinna. Some names just go together. Lisa Rinna. Almost sounds like one name, doesn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. What star who appeared in Three Men and the Baby and Cocoon also appeared with Lisa Rinna in Police Academy? Okay? And on our show today, the great singer Wynonna will be out here in just a minute.
We have absolutely worn out Wynonna's last record, her last CD. Cody is a huge fan of Wynonna. Wynonna and Seal. There's nobody else in the music business, and he does like My Lullaby album, thank goodness. But Wynonna, we go out to Colorado, it's the first thing we do is stick Wynonna in the CD. You haven't lived until, I think he was four when he learned to sing She Is His Only Need. That's a difficult song.
And he sings it?
Oh, yes, and nobody else is allowed to in the back seat of the Jeep. She is his only need. Coming out of a four-year-old. His only need is a diaper, you know? But they're talking about these serious
subtexts. Yeah, right, exactly. Cody is beyond his years.
Way beyond. She has a fabulous new CD. You're always afraid that you love a CD so much that the next one you're not going to like as much. This is incredible. It's called Revelation. She's going to sing for us today, The Power. Now, it's also... she's also
got two of them, actually.
This CD, The Power of Peace, which is in support of CARE. I think it's the 50th anniversary of CARE.
All right.
Olympic gold medal wrestler. What a story.
Kurt Angle, yes, indeed. In fact, you all remember this picture from the Olympics. This was on the cover of the USA Today. Here he was thanking God, I guess, and everybody else who had something to do with his win there. But he won the championship from the Iranian.
Yes.
It was a very exciting match, and he'll be out here in just a moment.
We had a very tough year because his dear friend Dave Schultz had been murdered.
Killed in that,
okay. Anyway, Eric Roberts is also here with us in a new film called Dark Angel.
Four
new stations, Reach.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. All right. So let's welcome these stations, then we'll get there. From Flint, Saginaw, we thank you very much for joining us. WJRT.
And WDBJ, Roanoke, Lynchburg, Virginia.
And down in El Paso, KDBC. Thank you all very much. Now, here we're going to Pat Vara in Palace Park, Illinois, out in Chicago. How you doing, Pat?
I'm just fine. It's Pat Vavra.
Vavra.
Yes, it's great to hear from you. This is wonderful.
That's an interesting last name. What nationality is it?
My husband's Bohemian.
Bohemian?
Yes.
From Bohemia?
Yes.
Where is
Bohemia? I didn't think Bohemia was a country. I thought that was like a term, you're a Bohemian.
State of mind.
Well, I think it's out of Slovak.
Slovenia.
It's a shout out. Shout out the great Wrigley Building out there in Chicago.
Oh, yes,
Boy, Chicago's got this great architecture downtown. It's just
beautiful. It does. It's the best, yes.
Absolutely. Well, Pat, the question was, who starred with Lisa Rinna in the 1984 film Police Academy. He also appeared in Three Men with a Baby and Cocoon.
Steve Guttenberg.
That's good for you. Very good. Please pick a number between 1 and 123.
Well, I have 7 children, so I'm going to say 7.
7.
Congratulations, Pat. You and our lucky audience winner have each won a Bassett blanket chest. Bassett's Eden House collection features beautiful cherry finish, cedar-lined blanket chest with a lift lid and tension springs furnished by Bassett. We keep value in style. Your prize is valued at $765.
All right, hope you enjoy that blanket chest. It sure looks like a beauty. Well, baseball is going to honor one of its own tonight over at Shea Stadium. He's been with the Los Angeles Dodgers for an unbelievable 47 years, 20 of those as manager of the Los Angeles Dodgers. Just newly retired. Everybody loves him.
He's a sweetheart.
Here's the ambassador to baseball, Tommy Lasorda.
Look how handsome you look.
How are you, Tommy?
Good to see you.
Thank you. Thank you for your lovely letter.
How beautiful you look. You look terrific, Tommy. Great, great to see you. Stand right over here, and we'll all just stand here, I guess, and talk. So, how does it feel?
Feels different, believe me.
Yeah.
It was a very emotional time for me, Regis. I had to give up something that I loved very, very dearly. And having been the manager for 20 years, and then I got to thinking about my granddaughter, Emily Tess, and I thought about my wife, Joan, daughter, Laura, and son-in-law, Billy, and I said, wait a minute. And there was no reason for me to take a chance down there. The Dodgers, Peter O'Malley and Fred Clair, were just simply great to me. They made me a vice president, and I will be in charge of looking at players, evaluating players, scouting players, and that's something I love to do, so.
You'll have more power than ever now, Tommy.
That's right.
Yeah, but here in New York, Bobby Valentine says, I want him with me.
Well, you know, Bobby played for him. He's like my son. He and Billy Russell last night going against each other.
Isn't
both of them were like my sons. Both started with me when they were 17 years old, and here they are managing against each other. Bobby used to say, boy, I can't wait till we're all in the major leagues together. And by golly, he did get a major league job, and I'm proud of him, and I think he's going to do a good job for this ball
club. So you're not going to come to New York?
No, I'm not going to come, only to visit.
Only to visit, okay.
And pull for Bobby.
You know, Tommy, when you had it, I had one of those about 3-4 years ago, and I thought, well, gee, you know, they're going to do it, clean it up. He'll be out of there and back on the field in a matter of days.
But you didn't have the surgery, Reach.
You didn't have to manage.
Yeah, the right. Well, yes, I do have to manage.
But, no, you
have
the surgery.
Yeah, but not 25 guys.
No, but one woman is stronger than 25 guys. Tell me exactly what you went through there.
Well, you know, I had that angioplasty, and I lost about 25 pounds. And the doctor told me, he said, the first 3 months are very, very important. I said, what do I have to do not to come back here? He said, number one, you got to keep your weight down. Number two, he says, you have to eat properly. Number three, get rest. And number four, exercise. And that's exactly what I'm doing. If I went back to managing, I can't be exciting.
You do get
screaming
excited
and hollering.
Look, you do scream
once in a while.
Yeah.
Once in a while. And I just thought that it wouldn't be best for me to go down there. I wouldn't be myself. And I thought it'd be best for me not to. But I say, I thank Peter O'Malley, Fred Clair. The Dodgers showed me how much they love me.
Well, they love you a lot.
Tonight they're honoring me at Shea. They honored me the other night in Philadelphia. They honored me the day before that in Montreal, the Expos.
It's on the Grand Tour. You're on the Grand Tour.
Yeah, but you know something? I can't believe I've been completely overwhelmed in the way the people in this country have reacted and concerned with me. When I got sick, it was just unbelievable. I can never, ever thank them enough.
You're one of the heroes, believe me. Well, you know, this really is some story, an ongoing story. 47 years, and I remember faithfully you coached the Dodgers all those years during Walter Alston's tenure. How long did Walter stay?
Walter stayed 23 years.
And you waited.
Yeah, when I got the job, a guy interviewed me. He said, you're replacing a guy that's been here for 23 years. He said, do you hope to match that record? I said, buddy, all I want to do is live 23 more years. And here I am.
And you did it. Tommy, congratulations on a terrific job.
Good to see you.
You're the best.
Thank you, Kathy.
Everybody loves Tommy Lasorda. Everybody loves you. Right back with Wynonna in a moment.
Still ahead on Live, 1996 Olympic wrestling gold medalist Kurt Angle. Actor Eric Roberts tells us about his new television movie. And coming up next, country singing star Winona.
Well, we're here with Chess Club Captain Marty Harper, who won't switch to Gladlock zipper bags.
These are my good luck bags.
Well, little Marty, what if we shove this pond scum into schoolyard thug Larry Zuger's locker? In either your bag or the Gladlock bag with the yellow and blue make green seal. Your bag doesn't have a green seal, smart man.
I think the smart move would be Gladlock.
When it really counts, get Gladlock. Guys, it's awfully humid in here, guys.
Okay, ladies.
Meet the proud creators of Post Waffle Crisp cereal. Harnessing good old-fashioned waffle know-how. Okay. Make sure every bite of Waffle Crisp tastes just like Grandma's homemade waffles and syrup. And how?
You'll love my Waffle Crisp.
With the new Energizer on-battery tester, you just press the dots to make sure your battery will keep going and going. With news like this, all we really have to do is show the battery. Just the battery. Thank you.
Will too.
Will not.
Will too.
Will not.
What are you guys arguing about?
He says we won't sell any cars as long as that factory authorized clearance is going on.
Will too.
Will not.
Will too.
Will not.
Just announced, get $600 cash back on all remaining 96 F-150 regular cabs.
That's not fair.
$600 cash back on remaining 96 F-150 regular cabs is a limited time offer. See your Quality Plus Ford dealer before Ford's factory authorized clearance ends.
Maybe they'll run out of cars and we'll get some of our customers back.
We live that long.
Boscov's Eddie Awards, the lowest prices of the year from our vendors, extra savings for you. It's our most incredible VCR buy ever, $159.99 for this sharp forehead super picture VCR with VCR Plus, built-in shuttle control, and every other wanted feature. From Cost, the best name in sound, $79.99 for this three-piece portable CD player with dual cassette, equalizer, and remote during the Eddie Awards at Boscov's.
She is so good.
Winona, yeah. All right, she's one of the premier talents on the country music scene, selling more albums than any other female country artist. Her current CD is called Revelations. She's also featured on the benefit CD, The Power of Peace, in support of care. Always a pleasure to have you here. Here is Winona.
Yes. She's saying such nice things.
You betcha. Winona. Winona is back.
You know that's
right.
Well,
you had kind of a layoff, didn't you?
A layoff?
Giving birth is not a layoff.
You don't know the pain. Oh, yes,
excuse
I was
me.
Off.
I had kidney stones once.
Here we go. Twice.
And I've got a mysterious pain right now that's actually killing me, but I say nothing. No, I know. Giving birth must. I can't imagine myself doing that.
Well, it's like it's.
You're not the only one.
It's like passing a pot roast through your nose.
No. A hot pot roast or a cold?
Hot. Oh, very hot.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm back on the road, and I'm going global. So please come see me on the road.
But they will.
Speaking of the road, I just brought these for you, Kathy Lee. That's me at Walmart.
Oh, bless your heart. Here she is.
The Kathy Lee collection photo.
Thank you very much.
Did you pick up some Kathy Lee hose?
Yes.
I'm wearing some right now.
Oh, thanks for the support.
Control top is so good. That's so sweet of you. That's funny.
Your hose is $14.96? Really?
Yeah.
$14.99 for that I paid.
For the hose?
No, for the shirt I got.
Oh, the shirt. Oh, okay.
Thank you. I'm going to treasure these.
So, Winona, what's it like to come back after a layoff like this?
It's very wonderful to now just enjoy singing. I don't have to be pressured to be number one all the time. After you have kids, you know how it is. You don't have the...
Your priorities change.
Well, you have a family, and you have balance, and you have sort of a real job, and it makes you humble.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I appreciate the fans now more than ever because I realize, you know, that if it wasn't for them, I'd still be at home. So they brought me out.
So they made you get out every now and then.
That's right.
Are you taking both kids with you everywhere?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You got that family bus going? Arch and the kids.
Arch and the kids.
And you?
We were talking about Velcroing up and down the sides of the bus and making them little Velcro suits and just kind of
so right against the wall.
What has been the most surprising thing to you about being a mom?
Oh, the most surprising thing, I think you know, the daily diaper thing. That's sort of the...
How often that needs to be changed?
That and just how much work it is. And I took a year and a half off without a nanny or anything, so I learned that it's just really hard. Life is hard, but you do what you can and you have your faith, which gets you through, and you just keep on keeping on. You know how women are out there? You just do what you have to do. And no complaining. No time for complaining.
No whining.
This is the no whining tour.
All right.
We're going to come back.
You should name your new bus.
We're going to come back and get a sample of that tour when Winona sings for us.
Still ahead on Live, actor Eric Roberts.
A frisky cat is full of catitude, and you know where he's getting his frisky attitude. Friskies gives your cat 42 vital nutrients and the famous Friskies taste he loves. Friskies brings out the frisky in your cat.
Cappuccino.
New Amaretto Cappuccino from Maxwell House.
A lot of folks need peace of mind these days, and that's just what they get with NAPA Auto Care's Peace of Mind Warranty. Repairs are guaranteed on both parts and labor for 6 months or 6,000 miles anywhere they travel. And when they use the NAPA card, their guarantee doubles to 12 months or 12,000 miles. How do I know our customers find peace of mind here? Because I own this shop, and their peace of mind is guaranteed.
We keep America running.
After 25 years comes the triumphant return of one of the theater's most powerful events. It's a spiritual experience that will move you. A musical experience you'll never forget. It's the greatest story ever told. Jesus Christ Superstar. The show that rocked the world. Featuring the magnificent music of Andrew Lloyd Webber and the haunting lyrics of Tim Rice. Starring from the original cast, Ted Neely as Jesus. On stage September 15th at the FM Kirby Center. Tickets available now.
In all my 35 years of practice, the most sensitive issue I deal with as an attorney is medical malpractice. I'm Tom Foley, the Foley Law Firm. No one wants to believe that they're...
the best and worst of Hollywood's past.
We got the Sunshine Boys.
That's Eddie, a showbiz veteran. Trivia fans may remember him as one of Spike Jonze's sidekicks.
I opened this in 1968 as a hobby. This is a part-time thing, and now you can see it's taken over myself, the whole family. The kids were born here. Heidi and Donovan were both born in the store.
Well, he exaggerates, but not by much. Eddie's son, Donovan.
My first illustrious job was sweeping floors at about 8 years old, 9 years old.
Okay. Now, are you looking for strictly the one sheets or...
That's Donovan's sister, Heidi, their mother, Claire, and Knuckles, the family dog. They're surrounded by 38,000 tapes of old movies and TV shows, 500,000 posters and stills, and not a single Quentin Tarantino film in sight.
New arrivals.
Today's new stuff, Marlena Dietrich in Angel, 1937. Rita Hayworth in The Loves of Carmen, 1948. Douglas Fairbanks in The Black Pirate, 1926. A Fairbanks fan snaps it right up.
I've gotten very involved in silent films. I find that I can concentrate on them more because the dialogue doesn't get in the way, if that makes sense.
Here's that double whoopee for you, Dave.
The Brants say silent movies seem to make perfect sense to a new generation of fans.
Seems the younger they get, the older the films they like. We probably have 70 or 80 people regular that are under 30 and also watch silent films.
I came in for coconuts from my six-year-old.
400 miles of hard racing today.
Sir Scott, we're expecting a lot of wheel-to-wheel battle, probably a real big draft of cars. You know, obviously it's important to get to the finish. We're hoping, you know, obviously not starting as good as we'd like with the Delphi car, but we're going to hope to use that draft, improve our car. Delphi guys give us some good pit stops today, and we're going to get ourselves up there and be able to challenge at the end of the race.
Good luck.
Some of the stories we're going to keep track of today, of course, that championship race. And the rookie race is very tight as well for Rookie of the Year honors. It's Thomas Schechter's birthday. He's 23. We'll see how he does here today. And power parity among the engines? Well, in the top of the field there, 3, 3, and 8. I mean, it is so close right now in the engine department. In car and onboard cameras, we have plenty of them. And the race distance at 200 laps, that's 400 miles. First pit stop come as early as lap number 18. Average distance to a pit stop would be 40 laps. Our onboard cameras, 10 different cars, 11 different angles available for you today. Now let's go to Jack Arut.
Roger Penske once said that luck is where preparation meets opportunity. For this man, that's the formula for success. He has two cars that are in the hunt for the title, and he has 11 championships on his side of the ledger. Gary Gerald, if you're a betting man, you go with the man who's got 11 to get 12 in 03.
Chip Ganassi has four titles to his credit. You've been down this road. Is there a key to winning championships?
Well, it's, you know, team targets put ourselves in a position all year, Gary, to be where we are today. You know, we're 12 points out of the lead. Right now, first order of business, be in front of Castro Neves at the finish. Second order of business, win the race.
Let's go to Jerry Punch.
Well, Gary, Michael Andretti may be the newest and least experienced owner among the championship team contenders. However, his freshness from the cockpit gives him a better understanding of the total focus it takes for a driver to get the job done. And over these final two races, that makes him a huge asset and ally for his driver, Tony Kanaan. Paul?
Johnny Rutherford in the Chevrolet Corvette pace car has already turned for the pit row. There is the front row. Elio Castroneves on the inside. Kenny Breck sitting high on the track. The field very pretty as they roll to the line for what should be an incredible race. Already, they're on the way. Tightly bunched down through the first corner. You ride with Tony Kanaan. Elio Castroneves poked his nose ahead of Kenny Breck, picked up the lead on the start. Big bump there going into turn four. See how high Tony Kanaan is? A green and white car sitting back fourth.
Paul, we heard Tony talk about learning lower downforce. That means not so much wing angle, front and rear, as they're already going three abreast going here into turn one. If you don't have too much downforce on the car, and the car actually will go faster down a straightaway, but not as much grip in the turns. These guys have to find that right balance that we talked about to be able to run the car fast down the straight and handle through the turn.
Kenny Breck got his nose ahead at the line. Elio Castroneves came back. You also saw Tony Kanaan slide into third place. Breck now runs very high. This is Sam Hornish on board. Now what you see on the lens, and we clear it here for you, but that's an oil spray that came from some car ahead of him.
Looks like possibly Barron's car. So right now that oil that's coming up onto the screen is also getting on the racetrack. The observers all the way around the racetrack will be back to the IRL officials in the booth saying car 52 is spraying oil. If it continues to do that, he'll have to come into the pits and have that looked at.
There is the 52 car down low. That's Vitor Mera up high. And they're continuing on pace back on board with Hornick as he comes inside Vitor Mera. Back to the front of the field. Tony Kanaan slides into second place. Dan Weldon comes up behind Tony Kanaan and tries to get around Kenny Breck. Hasn't done it yet.
Using the slingshot, getting that draft from the car up in front. The car in front breaks the air for you, and you get that shot to go around, and you've got to time it right to carry the speed through and make the pass clean.
Danny Weldon comes on around too. Kenny Breck has fallen all the way back into fifth place now. The combination of Kanaan and Weldon is going to be fairly important. They're teammates. If Weldon can do it, he needs to help Tony Kanaan on his fuel mileage. At the same time, though, Weldon is only 10 points behind Roger Yasukawa in the rookie fight, so he'd like to just run a race of his own.
Absolutely. You know, as a rookie, he wants to do all the right things for the team because he wants to remain there for next year. But the key thing he's trying to do also, as you mentioned, Paul, is to win that championship. He also wants to win the race today. He's been so strong throughout the year many times. Maybe there's a possibility for him to win today, too.
And you're beginning to wonder whether or not this guy, Thomas Schechter, isn't in the position out of Chip Ganassi's team to be the rabbit and try to pull the rest of the field away from his teammate, Scott Dixon, who currently sits back in fifth place.
And what happened there was Schechter trying to go around Kanaan. Kanaan went to go to the right-hand side also, but with Schechter being there, he had to back off.
Take a look at this at the front of the field. Battle for the lead, and it's Schechter that gets the nose ahead. Just beyond the line, though. Last lap at 219 miles an hour. Sam Hornish is getting into this fight, too. That's Kanaan just ahead.
Now watch the bump over the suspension right here, going down the straightaway, right there. Such a large bump, it might play a part over 400 miles of racing here on deteriorating possibly the drive shafts and the wheels of the car.
Oh,
man, what
Hornish,
a great move.
As they go through a very tight turn four. That one underneath is Weldon. Last lap for Hornish was at 222 miles an hour.
You know, these guys had their final warm-up yesterday afternoon, so they haven't been in the car since about 4 o'clock. Track conditions change. The sun's beating down the racetrack today. Very slippery. And these guys just get out there and run those speeds as if they were doing it just an hour ago.
Schechter, Castroneves, Weldon, Hornish, Tony Kanaan. Kenny Breck continues to fade. Hornish makes another move. Tries to get on Weldon, sets him up on that high line. What he's been doing is dropping in and then using turn four to dart out.
And here he's flat on the throttle, not taking his foot off whatsoever. Very small hand movements right now. He's getting behind, getting the air coming off the car directly in front with Weldon, and hopefully getting that draft to be able to go around the outside.
This time Hornish decides to stay high on Weldon through two. We'll see if he can stay out there, which he decides to do this time. Tucking in last time didn't work for him.
All these lines these guys are running right now, Paul, give them some information for further in the race and also at the very end. We've seen Sam many times run the high line, which he likes to win races. If you can make your car work up there, and you continue changing it through the pit stops, you have the opportunity to make it work in the best place in the racetrack that you want it to work on for that run to the finish.
First 10 laps are complete, clean and green. Giafone, who started eighth, has a problem. He slipped back to 21st.
Now you can hear some bobbling when those guys are going into turn three. And Paul, we talked about the bump before. The wheels actually come off the ground when those cars go over that bump, and the wheels go so quickly and the engine spools up so quickly, it actually hits the rev limiter. Once it hits a rev limiter, the car lands after going over the bump, then it comes back down to about the 10,000 to 10,003 area these engines run at.
Still running a pace well above 221 miles an hour, Jenks.
I'm watching behind the leader, the guy who started absolutely last on the grid today. That would be Robbie Buell, started 22nd, and he is all the way up to 14th at the moment. He's picked up eight positions in the first 14 laps. Robbie Buell is one of those who has never competed in an IRL car here at California Speedway. He was here last year. In fact, he qualified, but after doing so, went into turn number one, crashed, and was unable to start the race. But Robbie Buell, who started in 22nd position, is moving up nicely here in the early going, Paul.
Right-hand side there, you can see this ongoing battle at the front of the field, Schechter and Castroneves. Now, the Penske team, the three-car of Elio Castroneves, their philosophy is just stay in the race until you get to the last quarter of it. course, the Ganassi strategy, that's just a little bit different. It looks like they're sending somebody out in front to try to pull the rest of the field away. How the day plays out is still to be known. Helio Castroneves. And got around Castroneves, picking up the lead. Kanaan still third. We're getting very close to pit stops. As a matter of fact, we've already seen one car in the 160th lap, which is what we've crossed over, is the opening end of the window. Anytime after that, if they come in fuel, they're going to have enough to carry them to the end. So you can do it anytime now. You probably have to do it within about six laps.
And Paul, look at your second place car, Helio Castroneves, to pull out the pit road in three laps.
And in the top three, it's Chevrolet, Toyota, Honda, but it's about to change. Castroneves to the inside, darts to the outside.
Not enough momentum to make it.
Looking outside, looking outside.
Sam Hornish talked about last week that he always loves to be up at the Chicago race on the high side of the racetrack on these types of tracks. Be interesting to see if any of his competitors will allow him to be on the high side when it comes down the last couple of laps. Or maybe he's trying something new, looking on the low.
Clear, clear.
Trying on the low side.
Wow, Tony Kanaan comes right in there.
Because Helio Castroneves knows he will pit in two laps. Does not want to get himself stranded on the outside, guys.
Yeah, but under the possibility that everybody is going to pit at the same interval, wouldn't he want to get track position?
Well, that's the key thing right now, Paul. These guys are trying for track position. Sam has done the right thing because we've seen the lead change in the pits also. And these guys are going to try and beat everybody else out and try and claim that low side of the racetrack.
Kenny Breck comes into the pits. Of course, he is in 20th position, 15 laps off of the pace. That long stop earlier, there's the signal.
Right along that white line that we talked about before. That's to let everybody else know behind you that you're coming in, so they will move up on the high side around you. So when you take your foot off the gas in turns three and four, they don't collect in the back of you.
Ellenser Jr. in the pits, but more importantly, here comes Castroneves locking the brakes hard.
Yeah, just as he locked him up, Tim Cindric told him, watch the speed limit, watch the speed limit. This is the longest drive of the day for Helio Castroneves. Why? Because his pit box is pit number one, all the way towards turn number one. He will dart onto the concrete that makes up his pit box. No changes anticipated on this car. But it will take a little bit longer, as you said, Paul, to fill the fuel, waiting to show it in the overflow. Oh, boy, it takes so long. And they are off and away. Nice stop.
Yeah, but, Jack, I saw the famous stick, so they timed that one out. They didn't need the full load.
Absolutely, Paul. It never came up into the overflow. And that's, we're going to start calling that the Goodyear stick. He loves it so much.
Do you really love it?
Well, you know, with all this new technology we have today in the radios and all that, and sometimes just the stick's going to be the simplest thing to use.
You're an old tech guy, aren't you? Look at it again. See that? See the stick waiting?
Hits the fuel, man. Tells him it's time to pull the fuel nozzle out from the car. And off Castroneves goes.
They've tried all kinds of different technology to signal the fueler. And
here's the signal again, going to go over the white line, both cars.
They've used LEDs in his visor and then on the nozzle and everything, and the stick's still pretty hard to beat.
Now, the key thing why these guys are locking up wheels coming into the pits is they're trying to carry as much speed as possible, not to waste time, right up to this pit speed limit, which is a black cone, which is right there on our left-hand side.
Leader Hornish, second place Kanaan. Dixon stays out, keeps the lead. Yeah, don't work one another too hard, boys.
Guys, what could be the final pit stop of the day if we stay green, or should be for Sam Hornish. He said no major adjustments, guys. I love the car. Excellent fuel mileage, four tires, routine pit stop. Gary Carroll, they got Sam Hornish full of fuel.
And waiting for the fuel, now rolling. Gets out ahead of Tony Kanaan. They also didn't go for any changes, only tires and fuel. Dixon will be in the next lap or two.
That's amazing. It's 100 degrees at this track. They've been racing head-to-head with exception of six laps of caution for a single caution. and no changes on those cars.
One big difference, though, when you've got Hornish and Kanaan bidding together, they go back out and they've got a dance partner.
Yeah, but not necessarily a friendly one, Jack. They're both in the points battle. They don't want to help each other too much. Dixon comes off of the lead and into the pits. Alex Barron moves to second place. Hornish should cycle into the lead after these stops.
Here comes the man. Pick your pick. The Phantom, the Iceman, the Quiet Kiwi. He answers to all. Final pit stop. Championship hopes on the line. One race to go next month in Texas. Off the jacks. Fueling complete. The Target Ganassi team is moving.
And the time stopped there. They didn't have to fill the tank. They're 30 laps from the finish.
9.8 seconds. What a terrific stop. See how aggressive he is on the pit exit there. As soon as he's outside the pit box, he can accelerate over that 60 miles an hour once he's left the speed zone, and he leaves A.J. Foyt the fourth behind.
And guys, being able to go those extra three or four laps means less fuel having to go into the car, and maybe that precious second or two they save could be big when we get down to the final five laps.
Well, we're going to find out right now if Hornish has enough momentum to follow in behind Dixon and slingshot past him, and Kanaan's going to have a look.
Kanaan works on Hornish. Dixon got out of the pits with a good roll, but remember, he's on quasi-cold tires. Hornish goes high. Fight for the lead. Can Dixon hang on to it?
We mentioned before the pit stop was going to be so important to get out in front of the group. Then make your choice of lines. I think that Dixon has improved his car throughout the day. I mentioned before, it didn't look like it worked in turn two for him. The wind has not picked up here today as we anticipated it would be, so that will not be a factor in the car's handling around this race course.
We look at another one of those tight finishes, aren't we?
I'm feeling it.
Oh, man. Last lap at 224 miles an hour. Hornish is chasing them. Same miles an hour as they came around, same speed. They've got traffic just ahead of them. Then there's a bit of a separation, almost 2 seconds back to Tony Kanaan. Hornish comes high, comes up
inside,
behind
inside,
the 52 car, inside. Uses that Clear. Wake of vacuum from the car. It helps him just enough. Dixon comes way high.
Dirty air from Hornish sends Dixon high, but I'll tell you, Sam got the benefit of the cars up in front. Aaron in the 52, all those cars up there created a big wake for Sam to take advantage of it. Just think of it as a motorboat, Paul. Those guys are up front, and look at him slice through traffic at 222 miles an hour.
Right, yeah, but Dixon's going to stay with him. You see him puff some burnt rubber off his left rear as they hit that bump going into three?
Well, actually, what I think that is on the four car right now, as you go over the bump, there is an overflow tank, a catch tank on the back of these cars for all the systems. So what you look for is maybe that's possibly going over the bump. Boy, they're getting real close there when underneath. Makes you wonder if Barron's having some problem with the car up there. But that overflow tank, Paul, sometimes going over that bump might just shoot some oil or debris up out of the tank if it's full.
Average speed at 205.2 miles an hour with four pit stops and six laps of yellow. We're watching the fight for the lead. There are now 20 laps to go. Stories of the day, Elio Castroneves still has the points lead but is running sixth. That's a bit of a surprise. Roger Yasukawa sits back in seventh place in the order, but his competitor in the rookie points fight, Dan Weldon, sits in fourth place. Thomas Schechter, the birthday present he has thus far, is the fact that he led 102 laps of the race. And power parity, look at that. Chevrolet, Toyota, Honda, 1-2-3.
As we rode along there with Dixon, using the gearbox a fair amount, going to the low side. Beautifully timed move.
Wow, does that work for him?
And guys, that's exactly what they told him a lap or two ago. 20 laps to go. Race with Hornish. Go for it now.
Nothing to lose. Got to get maximum points for the championship. If Dixon was to win, he'd leave here with a points lead.
Dixon and Weldon are the only guys that have turned laps above 224 miles an hour. Hornish drops into his wake. We kind of wondered what was going on with Elio Castroneves. There he is back in sixth place.
Paul, I checked with Tim Cindric about that scenario, and he says, we just lost valuable time on pit road. While all of the other teams were doing 9-second stops, Casper Neves had a 12-second stop. And you figure that out to be more than 120 yards per second. Well, it's costly out on the racetrack.
Yeah, but Jack, I can read the speed, too, and the leaders are doing 222, 223, and Castro Neves is doing 219.
I don't have an answer for you, buddy.
He just dropped the 217 on the last lap. Of course, he's in traffic now. Jerry Punch.
Well, guys, Sam Hornish just got the word in the pits. The word was time to launch the grenades, meaning turn it to full fuel, full power, and go after him, guys. We got to win this one to win a championship.
Well, he didn't take long to do it as he pulls up alongside of Dixon. Again, traffic ahead.
That information of full fuel, sometimes these guys have the knob on the dash, turns to minus one, minus two, gives them less fuel in the engine, allowing them to get better fuel mileage, but we're good enough to the end right now. It's full power, and the meter will be set on zero.
Just clear, clear, clear.
So Hornish to the front now, 15 laps to go. That dial changes the fuel mapping of the engine. Some of them even carry an extra position that they can only use with the permission of the engine manufacturer themselves. They got to go ask for permission to turn it on. And that's the total bomb setting. It gives you a lot of speed, but it doesn't do it for long.
Well, actually, some of them actually have a button on the steering wheel they can push, and it activates the system for about 10 seconds, gives it maximum fuel and maximum ignition. So sometimes you might see these guys use that, come up to a run to the flag.
Yeah, but that's in addition to this other teal, so they got some options. Now, lap traffic ahead, Ed Carpenter, and then Kenny Breck, race control, of course, making sure that the cars that the leaders are coming up on are well aware that they are there and asking them to give the position away, though Ed Carpenter comes up high on Dixon. Now he sees him, comes down the middle of the track.
Look at Hornish being able to pick his line. He's picked it high, he's picked it low. This is what these guys have worked for all day, to be in a position at the end of the race to have the opportunity to run towards the checkered flag.
We had mentioned the possibility that Hornish and DeFerrin might be eliminated from the championship fight based on their positions mid-race. Well, that's all changed now. Everybody's still back in the fight, and the separation's only 30 points. Here are the fastest laps today. We mentioned Dixon's at 224.1.
Wow, look at those speeds, 224s, 223s. When you think about how hot it is out here today and how hot the track is, that is amazing speeds. And you consider last year we ran this race in mid-50 temperature. Quite a departure from where we were a year ago.
Now, the reliability, I mean, look at it. Engines, chassis, 100-degree temperatures, tires work great, engines are working great. We've had two retirements, Hearn and Herden. Hearn was out because he bumped wheels with a 52 car.
It's been that way all year, and that's what they say this year is so important to qualify up front, because if you're off just a little bit.
10 to go this time by, 10 to go.
Sam Hornish gets the information, 10 to go. If you are off just a little bit in qualifying or the race, you won't be inside the top 10. Now these guys are flat out, Paul, not taking their foot off the peg whatsoever. Dixon's job is to follow in behind Hornish as closely as possible in a straight line to pick up any toe he can so he can get in a position to be able to make a run at him and make a move.
Tonight, NFL rivals collide on ESPN. Bills Dolphins at 8:30 on ESPN. Also available on ESPN HD. It all starts with NFL Primetime presented by Miller Lite at 7:30 Eastern. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. Don't forget our college football lineup next week as well.
Still speeds at 221, 222 miles an hour.
Tony Kanaan in third place, losing touch with the leaders now, 3.2 seconds back. But Dan Weldon is battling with him. And remember, they are teammates.
Remember, Dixon and Sam Hornish had two of the fastest stops in that last pit section. So that's what puts you up front. And the other guys have actually lost the ability to stay up in the draft. Now, if anything, it looks like Sam's being able just to pull away a small amount and maintain that lead that he's had lap after lap, which is just under a half a second.
This could be a historic race. The possibility of a 400-mile race being completed with an average speed above 200 miles an hour. Hornish works his way around Allanser Jr. Puts some separation now.
And you think about that, Allanser Jr. is in ninth spot. So these guys have lapped up to ninth right now. Scott Sharp with the Kelly team is currently running in eighth, and not a bad run from those two guys, Sharp and Unser, from what they've had over the last couple of races, just with some difficulties.
Allanser Jr., driver of this car, one of those who we're not really sure where he will be racing next year. Adds to all the mystery of these final races.
At this time of year, Paul, this is when the motorhomes are usually the busiest part in the garage area. Maybe not necessarily the garage, because all the drivers are knocking on doors looking for rides for next year.
All the focus now, though, is on the track and on the guy in front with five laps to go. Sam Hornish has now pulled out 0.8 of a second from Scott Dixon.
Sam looking to the left, looking in his mirror there.
0.6 seconds, lead.
Picked it up just a little bit that last time. Poncho Carter telling him 0.6 of a second lead. You'd love to hear that information when you're leading the race the next time around. He's going to want to hear 0.7 if he can make it that.
Oh, it goes to 0.5, so there's a little closing. In fact, there it is right there.
Now, one key thing that could play a part in this, Paul, is traffic. We've seen it happen all day long. Those two guys get an opportunity to be in touch with each other. That's Dixon having an opportunity to be close to Hornish. You know he'll hope for traffic up ahead.
Can you hold your breath for three laps?
Ready to go.
Dixon is right there.
See, he's running the high line, goes down towards the center, uses actually the angle of the banking to run down the hill a little bit to maybe gain just a bit of speed.
Before, there is a theory that the best position to be in on this kind of track is second place, being able to take advantage of the vacuum behind the lead car and slingshot past.
Two to go.
But he's going to have to make a big move this time, Paul, with two laps to go. He's going to have to get up in that area that's within about five or six car lengths to have that opportunity to be able to make that slingshot. Does not look like that's going to happen for him right now. Hear him off the gas there just a little bit. I still say he's fighting the car just a little bit in turn two.
Here comes the leader. Look back from Scott Sharp at the leaders coming toward him.
White flag.
2 miles to go.
Gas, the car's not working well for him, but Sam's got slowed up just a little bit in the high side there.
Clear.
Dixon has a little better momentum coming off the corner. Sharp comes up high. Dixon sees the opportunity, comes down low. But it looks like it's all Hornish.
Bring it on home.
Sam Hornish has won three of the last four races, and will now trail the points leaders by a mere 19 points. Sam Hornish has won at California.
Would you have thought in the middle of the season that Sam Hornish could be running for the championship at the last race of the season at Texas? What an amazing feat with that new Chevrolet engine.
So the finish is Hornish, Dixon, Kanaan, Weldon, and Castroneves and Dixon are tied for the points lead.
A brilliant sun.
Would have thought in the beginning of the season with the problems that Sam Hornish and the Pennzoil Panther team were having with their Chevrolet Gen 3 engine, that at the end of the season they would be fighting as valiantly as they are to defend their two-time IRL IndyCar Championship title. Sam Hornish has won here at Fontana, and in fact is the only driver in IRL competition to go to victory lane here in California. A two-timer now, Sam, congratulations.
Thank you. You know, the Pensil Panther team did an awesome job for me today in and out of the pits. The car was just, I could run wherever I wanted to, and that was the big key today. We definitely didn't have the fastest car, but we had the car that we could run wherever, and that's just really a great testament to these guys and what kind of effort they put into it.
Beginning of the race, reports coming out of your pits that there were some telemetry issues and radio issues. Just how deep did they go?
All the telemetry on my dash was okay, but they couldn't read anything, so it was basically, you know, every couple laps telling them what the fuel count was, what position I was in, and with the fuel mixtures and whatnot, and it was just a great day for us.
One more race, Texas. You're going to need a little bit of help, but you've needed a little bit of help throughout the course of the second half of this season. How committed are you to try to make it a three-time IRL titleist?
There's no point going out there if you don't want to win. So, we're going to go out there. We're going to do the best that we can. You know, we're doing everything that we can do. You can't do anything more than win the race, and that's all there is to it. So we'll go to Texas, and we'll try to make it three. They've got three in a row. With Scott Goodyear started it, and, I've got two wins there, and hopefully we'll make it four.
You're 19 points. Am I correct there, gentlemen? 19 points behind in the chase for the championship. It can be done.
It ought to be exciting. Let's see what happens.
Jerry Punch.
Well, Jack, one of five proud Pennzoil Panther owners, John Barnes. John, what a day. How can this young man overcome all he did? You guys had all kinds of radio problems, telemetry problems, and one won the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, I mean, it's just testament to the team. Andy Brown, I think, you know, he's the best. And we give Sam really good cars and really good pit stops, and he does the rest. I mean, he's fearless and just a great competitor.
You are not going to give that title up easily. You're going to be able to hang on and one more shot at it going to Texas.
Well, we'll see what happens. I mean, it's in the Lord's hands now, and he's got us here.
He made the calls today. Sam drove the car, and he ended up in victory lane. Let's go up pit road to Gary Jarrell.
And with Scott Dixon. Scott, you talked this week about the importance of winning championships boils down to winning races. Did you think you had an opportunity in the last 20 there to overhaul Hornish and win?
I thought we were pretty good, and, he came past us a couple of times, and I thought, we had a faster car. We could slingshot back, but our car was extremely good. At the start of the runs, and then we'd sort of just, be very average with the others. So, it's still a great day for Team Target and the points, and, congrats on Hornish for winning the race.
You're tied now for the championship lead. We talked a bit about the importance of being patient, and a couple of times I know on the radio today you were very upset with one of your colleagues out on the racetrack. Did you have a real close call?
It was very close, actually, with me and Tony in three. I don't know if he didn't know if I was there, but I came down and actually dipped under the line and nearly went straight back up into him. So it was close call.
So now you start thinking about next month and Texas. Are you looking forward to that kind of drama?
It shouldn't be too bad. I think we did a fairly, we had a fairly good test there last week. Actually, it started this week, and, Team Target's going to try their hardest. We're going to pull out all the stops, and Toyota have got plenty of things coming too, so I think we'll be pretty strong.
Gotta love the quiet, calm confidence, Bob.
Scott Dixon second. Sam Hornish wins the fastest race ever held. The average speed over 400 miles, 207.152. Back in a moment. Is tied. Both Elio Castroneves and Scott Dixon have 467 points. All five drivers are still eligible for the championship as we go to Texas. And Sam Hornish is only 19 behind. Jack Arute is standing by with the third and fourth place finishers today.
And teammates in the Andretti Green Racing mega team that has unfolded before our eyes this season. Let's start with the Klein Tools Jim Beam pilot. Dan Weldon, first official race here for you in the IndyCar competition. Grade yourself.
I don't know. The main thing was
we're from Texas.
Well, it's going to be the showdown. I think whoever finishes ahead at Texas will win it, and that's the way it should be, just like the